Brits' life expectancy has increased over the past decade, and therefore looking after our health as we age has become increasingly important. Joining me today to offer some top tips on leading a healthy lifestyle during our 60s and beyond is leading diet and fitness expert, Rosemary Conley. Rosemary, thanks so much for coming in.
It's a pleasure.
Now, Rosemary will also be here to discuss the findings of new research from the Department of Health as to how the over 60s view their own health and well-being. So, Rosemary, thanks so much for coming in. And people's attitudes towards health as they approach their 60s have changed somewhat because it's not old age anymore, is it?
No, I think when I was young, if you got to 60s, you were definitely a pensioner and really you weren't working and you just were grannies and you were old. Whereas you suddenly get there yourself, I have 5 years ago, and suddenly you think, crumbs, this isn't old at all. No. I feel just as fit as I did when I was 35. And so, you know, why give in to that? And I think there's a lot of people who fall into that category. And more you see film stars now looking fit and healthy into their 70s. And so you suddenly think, hey, life is for living. Let's just look after our bodies and really enjoy those latter years.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think as well, Rosemary, there's been some research recently where the survey found that almost a third of people would rather not go and see their GP, thinking that whatever their ailment was going to, you know, go away of its own accord.
I think the Department of Health has been sort of finding out how people feel about themselves. And one of the problems is that people, it's uncovered the fact that older people feel that if they do have a little niggle, it may be joints, it may be memory or whatever, they think, oh, I can't really go to the doctor, it's just me getting old. When in actual fact, they probably should go to the doctor and just get it checked out, because it could be that it's just nothing hugely important, but check it out. And if it is bad, and some of the reasons they don't go is because they fear it might be bad and they don't want to know, well, that's actually burying your head in the sand. That's not helpful to anybody. So you need to go and get it addressed, and if it is a serious problem, it can be dealt with earlier on much more easily than it can do later on. So don't be frightened of going to your doctor. You won't be wasting their time.
Now, that's the other thing as well. Perhaps some people are guilty of not going because they feel they're going to be a burden. They think, oh, he's already busy, I don't want to trouble him.
Yes, well, you know, that's what doctors are there for. And you shouldn't be worrying and having a decline in your sort of lifestyle and your everyday living just because you've got this problem, when in actual fact it may be something completely small and it can be cleared up with one course of tablets.
Yeah, absolutely. You know? Yeah. Or just a changing lifestyle, perhaps, you know, diet and exercise. This is obviously your expert area of expertise.
Exercise is such an important one. I mean, if we... The benefits,
more so, presumably, the older you get as well. It's not just for the younger generation.
The benefits from exercise are absolutely huge, but particularly important as we get older. And we haven't got to go on a treadmill for an hour. You know, let's just go for a 10-minute walk two, three times a day. If you can go for 30 minutes, terrific. Go to an exercise class where you have to sort of learn and think about the choreography, because that's good for the brain as well. I took up ice skating when I was 60. Fantastic. You have to really use your brain, but it really uses your muscles. So we need to work on our muscle strength. So standing up, sitting down, going up the stairs, that all helps that. And then aerobic fitness, which is going to help our heart stay healthy, and that lowers our blood pressure and all of those things. And get your weight down. That's a really important one. If your weight is up, you're carrying a holiday suitcase around with you possibly, and this could be really hard for you. No wonder you're going to be falling asleep in the afternoon if you're carrying that much weight. So eat healthily, get rid of that
weight.
Well,
that was my next question, because obviously it's twofold, isn't it? It's exercise, but it's diet. So, I mean, just there's 100 things we could do to our diet, but simply, what sort of things should we be doing?
I would say don't eat any high-fat snacks between meals. That's the biggest thing. Eat your three meals a day. Eat low fat as a matter of course. And just go gently on the alcohol. And just leave those high-fat treats, because, you know, if you want to be slim and you want to have a healthy future, then it's worth saying no to the chocolate bar and the cakes.
There you go. Good advice. Thanks ever so much, Rosemary. It was short and sweet. It was a pleasure to see you as well.
Lovely to see you too.
So there we are. We hope you enjoyed watching. Don't forget, of course, if you would like to learn more about staying fit and healthy as you get older, then get yourself online. It's allthews.nhs.uk/changeforlife. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.